What's under there, you think?
Ah, back to smashing through things for fun and profit. Lovely.
Mumira, what did you hear of Odin's offer?
To the lad? Not much. They stepped outside. But he told us about it. I wouldn't worry.
What about the things he did not tell us?
Remember when we fought our first troll out this way?
I remember you lost control.
We must tread carefully, brother. Danger is close.
You okay fighting without a shield?
It is not my first time.
No! Morte, bro!
Brother, there's no blocking without your shield! Right side!
Almost home.
Brother, a word. Don't hold the lad's curiosity against him. It goes with being young.
In my youth, we learned obedience.
Brother, he's going to walk his own path. If you don't want him walking away from you, then smarten up and walk with him a while.
If we could find a way to open Realm Travel to Svartalfheim, there'd be all sorts of useful equipment for us.
Enough. You will go.
Really?
But if we do not find Tyr, you will abandon your search for good.
All right. You won't be sorry.
Over here!
Sindri!
As I live and breathe, is that Atreus? It's been so long! How you've grown!
Yeah.
Well, if you'll follow me, Brock mentioned you needed somewhere safe to spend the night, and I believe your favorite dwarves can help you out with that. We're still your favorite dwarves, right?
You're still the only dwarves we know.
I'll take it. After you, my friends.
Where are we going?
The cleanest cabin in all the Nine Realms. And I'd prefer it to stay that way. Not looking at anyone in particular. Kratos. After that Thor incident, we thought we should make up some rooms. Till you can figure out your next moves. Nearly there. As you can see, we've settled here in the realm between realms. It's nothing much, but it's safe from Fimbulwinter, safe from Odin's eyes. And you really can't beat the view if you're into shimmering gray voids.
That's amazing, Sin. We have a plan to talk to you about, actually.
Intriguing. Come in. Come in! Now, if you would just wipe your feet very thoroughly, I'll wait. You're not gonna wipe your feet, are you? Okay then. Your bedrooms are there, the kitchen is just over there. Anybody need a snack? Kratos? Snack?
I do not need a snack.
What we need is your help getting to Svartalfheim so we can try and rescue Tyr.
To Tyr? Alive? I mean, that's... What?
It's okay. I told him everything.
Everything?
You aided my son in disobeying me.
No, I kept an eye on him. On your behalf. Nothing risky. Everything very safe. Somebody else speak.
What's important right now is that we try and open up travel between realms again. You said you know a way?
Yes, I do. It's just a lot of mud.
Then why haven't you opened the way already, man?
Well, to be frank, there was something we needed your help with.
Oh! The Huldra brothers finally require the services of the smartest man alive.
That's it precisely.
Hey! Not so fast! How'd that get in here? What the hell is it anyway?
That is my son.
Well, what in all yarns me the happened to him? He's too damn tall now. And he looks like that. I blame you. Now, come on then. Let's get him something that fits at least.
He's just getting older, you dark prat. Didn't you ever have an awkward phase in your youth?
Hey.
I suppose what's done is done. But you'll be putting your foot down from now on if you know what's good.
Oh, he's trying. Believe me.
All right, let's gear you fuckers up before you go off gallivanting.
Begin with this.
Busted up good. Wouldn't you rather I just whip you up a new one?
It is important to me.
In the meanwhile, how about I fix you up with something to get you by? Got materials to make one of these in the here and now. You bring me more resources, we'll see what we can do.
Alberto. This thing is a fucking bomb. Alberto.
If the kid's gonna insist on getting taller, best make a habit of swinging in for new duds.
Wow, wow, okay. I was gonna ask you something earlier, but fuck that shit. Oh wow, that's fucking crazy. My god. I won't crap under the well. No. Three defense, more strength. Ah, this nigga, shut the fuck up. Okay. I don't got enough armor, so yeah.
Found some items you left behind. Tossed them in the chest. What would you do without them?
I'm gonna go look around, check out my room. Tell Sindri when you're ready.
Frozen flame.
Keep her sharp and she'll keep you alive.
Snake. What's in here?
I knew he left something behind. Wait! Those stairs will not support you. Please don't break my house. See? I knew you wanted a snack. Finding everything all right, I hope.
How do we unlock the bells?
You'll just need something from back at the workshop. Follow me. Be sure to bring the
He said, be sure to bring the head.
He's imprisoned in a mine somewhere. That's all we know so far.
The realm is full of mines, you realize. We need help narrowing it down. Oh, you should talk to Derlin.
Who's Derlin?
He's a cousin of ours. Sort of. Works for the city on safety issues. Should have access to all kinds of information on mines. And I know he's no friend of Odin. That's why your mother sought his help when she was trying to whip up a rebellion. Ready?
A rebellion? Did you know about that?
I did not.
A rebel leader who knew mom. Sounds like exactly what we need.
I think you missed the ta-da. Well, never mind. I'll have this oiled up in no time. Meet you at the gateway outside.
Rebel leader? Derlin? If that ain't giving a hound a haircut.
Huh?
And you? You just remember things however they pop into your being, don't you? I suppose you think Derlin's just counting the days until a couple of strays show up looking for trouble.
What do you mean, Brock?
Will he help us or not?
No, never mind. It ain't old Brock's place to cast aspersions on my relations. This smudge sponger notwithstanding.
Ignoring you.
Fine. Go darken Derlin's door. See for yourself how it goes. Just be warned, he's not the friendly sort of dwarf folk you're used to. He's cranky as all get out. And he talk funny, too.
Sounds like a true study in contrast.
I've always wanted to see your home realm. Svartalfheim sounds unique.
Svartalfheim? Stupid Aesir name. We look like dark elves to you.
Oh, right. You call the realm something else.
Nidavellir, which is also the name of the capital city and where you should look for Derlin.
Damn city's so full of Odin fuckers nowadays. It ain't hardly somewhere a self-respecting dwarf would show his face.
Harsh, but accurate.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
You hear that?
Vamanus.
We'll just need the Bifrost in the head. Brock?
Do the touching.
Oh, this would be the part requiring my assistance, then.
You said it. This device here has been crafted to your measurements. It'll help you get a better look at the problem with those Bifrost eyes of yours.
So, do I control this thing somehow, then?
Oh, no. This is just to hold you in place while we shine this light in your eyes.
Oh! Oh, Cindy, you stodding bastard! Oh!
Open! Open now! I was really hoping not to use the eyelid clamps.
Do it!
That's it! That's it! Good! Now, release!
Still unpleasant!
Oh, that's our cue! Come on, hurry!
I'm coming!
Russell just eggs, man! What was that for?
You'll see soon enough. Just there! That should do it! See? No permanent damage.
I'll show you permanent damage, you wee fuck! Gritos! Throw me at him! Horns first!
Case you takes a joke, you old goat!
The Bifrost is broken.
Now that we've reconfigured these gateways to use Yggdrasil seeds, you won't need a travel table or a Bifrost lamp anymore.
I also used it for light.
Okay, good note. I'll figure something out, but first, come on, let me show you how it works. Okay, aim your key at the rune for Svartalfheim on the right, then concentrate.
Thank you.
This should take you to the wetlands outside Nidavellir City. Just make your way to the town square and ask for Derlin at the tavern.
You sure they'll know him at the tavern?
Derlin's always been an inveterate inebriate. I suppose he might have completely changed, but in my experience, eh.
Did you want to come with us?
Oh, I might drop in, but the wetlands are moist. And the grim are everywhere. Hostile, slimy, foul-smelling creatures. But good luck!
Thanks. Wait, what?
I said good luck!
Whoa! Do you feel that?
What's that, lad?
Anything. Everything. It's warm. We can probably use this boat. If I can just get it free.
Careful, lad.
Ah! Why are these things so fast? Behind you, father! Behind you! Incoming! Behind you! Another red! To the left!
I see we're already off to a lively start.
Atreus, you dropped your guard.
I got the boat free, though. You can head through these channels when you're ready. Chain in the water for?
That'd be a dwarven supply ferry. Said ferry appears to be missing.
Huh. I still can't believe Mom led a whole rebellion here, against Odin, and never talked about it.
The fact that it didn't go well might have covered that notion.
What your mother did before we met was her business.
Did you ever ask?
Eyes on the water. There are resources.
You never asked Mom about what she used to do. What did you talk about when you met? Like, did you just say...
Woman, guard the house. I will go to catch fish in the river.
And then leave for 5 days?
No. Your mother was far better at fishing than I.
Did you see that over there?
Channel.
I imagine if you can turn it, we should be able to get through.
So these are wetlands, huh? Pretty accurate.
It is a bog.
The smell is making my eyes burn.
You know, it is a fair bit more potent than when I last visited, now that you mention it.
Looks like the path continues on the other side of that geyser. If only we were in Midgard. That water'd be frozen in a second.
Brother, do you think freezing it would work?
What if you use your axe on it?
Looks to be an artifact from the Dwarven Resistance. Raid Mars Brassard, father of a few dwarves you may be well familiar with. Brock may be interested in getting these back. Better in his hands than out in the open.
Think that's dirty enough to burn?
Aye. Good old dwarven craftsmanship.
Tyr was a friend to the Giants. I wonder if he and Mom ever met. If he was a part of the rebellion here.
It's certainly possible. The God of War often advocated for the Giants. Although I don't recall if he ever declared allegiance outright.
Okay, there's got to be some way to turn the wheel up here.
Well there! Give a man some warning if he's about to suddenly end up snout deep in cheek.
The ground.
Was that an earthquake?
An occasional but not unheard of happenstance in Svartalfheim. With all the mining here, the land's bound to be a wee bit bothered.
Think you can reach the wheel from here? Oh, wow. Nice job getting it to lower exactly where we need it. I was thinking, because it's so warm, maybe it's not that the cold hasn't made it here yet, but maybe it's just different in Svartalfheim?
Aye, lad. Fimble winter doesn't strike all realms quite the same way.
Weird that Fimble winter doesn't always make it winter.
In Midgard it does, but as you can see, the effects here appear far more gaseous in nature. Observe the geysers. Observe the aforementioned aroma. These effects were present before in some form, but now there's new extremity to them.
Left side! Incoming! Father, there.
Find anything good up there?
Behind you!
They cap those geysers? I think we need to get that wheel moving, but the water doesn't reach. Yes! The wheel's moving and the gate's coming down.
That's dwarven ingenuity for you.
Back to the boat.
If the dwarves of this realm are anything like Brock and Sindri, it's hard to imagine them siding with Odin.
Well, all too often, people are blinded to all but their immediate self-interest. Odin offered them safety, and defying him can be quite dangerous.
Maybe they just need a couple of gods to come along and take the fight to him.
Atreus, that is not why we are here.
I was only joking.
War is not a joke, especially where gods are concerned.
I'm trying to keep our options open. Let's just keep moving. I'm glad we're out here, exploring a new realm. Maybe we could just try to enjoy the warmth? Looks like we gotta find a way to open that gate if we want to get to Nidavellir. Fast.
Then how shall we catch it?
Flank it. Attack from behind.
Good.
Did it. Let's see what it draw. Father, up there. halfway there. There's gotta be another chain to lower the rest of the gate. Look, there's a chain we can pull up there. It's clinging to the wall! We gotta knock it down! You can uncover that geyser from here. Oh, I think I get it. If you freeze the geyser, the pressure will turn the wheel. Block's coming down. Hey, nice one. Is there something else we can hit?
Try hitting the rope holding the block.
Do you see anything from that block?
That's one of Cavassier's poems. Very highbrow. You should collect any others you find. Exactly are you hoping to learn from Tyr?
Well, like I said, I was hoping he could tell me something about Loki. I'd also like to hear some of his stories. traveling to other lands, giant stuff, and maybe about what it was like to fight back in the day. Just for the history, obviously.
History?
Let's hope Tyr's in a talkative mood after being imprisoned for so long. Not all of Odin's captives can be as charmingly voluble as myself.
We have no proof Tyr is truly here.
Right. That earthquake earlier. Do you think there will be another one?
It's unlikely, but geological disturbances tend to be unpredictable.
If the geysers and smell here are worse because of Fimbulwinter, maybe the earthquakes are too?
Aye. You might be onto something, lad.
Atreus, look ahead.
Wow. Now this looks like a city.
Welcome to Nidavellir, brothers.
Hey, dwarves! Oh. They're, running away.
An alarm.
I'd only sound an alarm like that if I still had my body, and was fearing the notion of being detached from it.
Why all that for us, though?
They are scared.
Was definitely an alarm, I'm afraid.
Why is everybody hiding?
Stay alert.
Could we talk to you for any trouble, please?
There'll be no help, to be sure. Best we find the tavern Sindri mentioned on our own, and hope they let us in.
The buildings here really are incredible.
The detail in the woodwork is quite extraordinary.
Is that a statue of Odin? They must really love him here.
Or fear him.
Sindri! Hello. I'd return your surprise, but I did know you'd be here. I've got something for you.
Appreciate it. What is a dwarf?
You know, I'm glad I came back here at least once before Ragnarok. Oh, if these cobblestones could talk. Then they'd have mouths. Filthy, disgusting mouths. Do you mind if I fiddle with your bow? You are long overdue for a replacement. Taking advantage of certain material... Ow! Structural sensitivity to sonic vibrations has been something... I've been meaning to try for quite some time now.
Thanks for, finally trying it. What's it gonna be this time?
Patience! I find it's best to see these things... in action! There. Oh, take aim at that gate there. But before you loose, say, Skialfa. Skialfa.
Well, I certainly didn't expect you to disturb half the creepy crawlies in Nidavellir.
How was I supposed to know they were there?
Right.
Okay, so, Derlin. Sindri, any idea where the tavern is?
Do I look like I've ever been to a filthy tavern? The sewer you just punched a hole through seems promising, though. For you. It should lead to the other side of the city. It's not like you're able to open other doors around here.
Atreus, this way.
Best of luck.
Seems like me the Valyrs locked down because of us.
Outsiders are not welcome here.
I imagine that large statue of Odin has something to do with it.
Well, everyone's hiding on this side too.
Odin's occupation of this realm has its hooks in deep.
But there aren't any guards patrolling. We're clearly not a threat. Why hide?
Resist and you're made an example of, to keep the rest in line. Self-preservation can outweigh bravery for even the strongest of folk.
Fear keeps them safe and alive.
A firebomb from the chief anti-Odin propagandist in Durland's rebellion. Quite a sharp witch he had until he turned to half subtle means of resistance.
This looks promising, right? Well, it's like a house. If he's here, maybe you should let me do the talking.
You?
Well, we don't want to intimidate him. You're tall as a tree and you have a severed head on your head.
None taken. Fair point, though.
Very well.
Think that's him? Hello?
Watch yourselves. Apparently, there are intruders about.
Oh, that's us, I think.
Well, if you're planning on killing me, at least let me finish this song. That alarm was in just the perfect key.
We're just looking for a friend of ours named Derlin.
Well, we both know that's not true. Durlin's got no friends left. But if that's all you need, head out the back way there, and you'll see the safety office just across the river. Just don't go making trouble for the rest of us. And while you travel through this realm, maybe you could clean up the head's mess?
What mess?
Later, brother.
I wish to hear of this mess.
The rig's in the bay. Why don't you ask the condescending skull?
Head, I've got skin. But he's right. I made a mistake. I'd have us shut them down.
Sorry, one more thing. Although, these are gifts I'm giving to you, so I shouldn't be sorry and you should be thankful. Anyways, here. Please be careful.
It's beautiful. Thanks, Sindri.
It is beautiful, isn't it? It's also very useful. You'll be able to find anything your heart desires with it.
Really?
As long as your heart desires the locations your father and you decide and plot to travel together, then yes.
It is a compass.
Ah, but a beautiful compass. Now scamper off.
Come. A boat cannot be far.
Huh. Earlier, Sindri made it sound like Durlin was a family in war. Doesn't sound like anyone's following him.
Was being the key word here, little brother.
I saw a dock back there. Maybe there's a boat we can use to get to Durlin's.
There's a building just past these rocks behind me. Maybe we should head that way.
Ugh, those bloody mining rigs.
What about them?
The Skald is right to blame me for them. They were my idea. If you've got the time, they're in the bay just beyond this tunnel.
I particularly appreciate us checking out the mining rigs in the lake to the right. You can see the smokestacks from here.
But if you don't want to explore now, it looks like Durlin's place is through that open gate to the left.
So, which way do we go? We could prepare more before rescuing Tyr. Up to you. Mimir, are you really the one who had those rigs built?
Odin wanted the dwarves under his control, and, well, I convinced him he could buy their allegiance instead of demanding it outright. A trade agreement of sorts.
One of the mining rigs is here?
See the smoke above us? That's where we're headed. Let's see if we can't shut it down.
If the dwarves didn't like working for Asgard, couldn't they just quit?
And do what? Their newly built forges poisoned the soil of Svartalfheim. Unable to grow their own food, they had to buy it from Asgard. If they stopped working, they'd be taking food out of their own mouths.
Oh, that's clever. And awful. To Muspelheim. Think it might lead to that combat arena we visited years ago?
What makes you say that?
Wishful thinking, I guess. Going through Surtur's gauntlet, it was fun.
It was training.
You didn't have fun? Well, anyway, we should look for the other half of the seed. Once it's whole again, we can see where it leads. Make it across.
Spawning a little wretch is like there's no tomorrow.
For her, it will be so.
Yeah.
block with materials that could help us. I'd grab whatever it spits up in the process.
To the deal with Asgard, why do they blame you?
I talked them into their own exploitation.
They need their choice.
Work or die is not a choice. I only made it seem so. What you just picked up there is pure Svartalfheim ore. It won't be of use in the rig anymore, but perhaps our Huldra brothers could craft something from it. Good thing you learned the runes, brother.
Father, is it always moral to kill something that's trying to kill you?
Yes.
Well, there you have it, lad.
did these rigs come to be?
I had them built to harvest ore for armaments. Essentially harnessing resources that would otherwise go to the dwarves.
You think shutting these things down will help the dwarves become independent?
I don't know, but I have to try something.
Taking a break before visiting Durlin? Very wise. He can be a lot.
Oh, wow. It seems useful.
At your service. By the way, if you're headed to the mining rigs in the bay, could you bring me any slag you find? I could use the material for my crafting. What can I make for you? I'll disinfect my tools. Nothing appeals to you?
There's another mining rig on this island, brother. Smell that smoke?
Why would the dwarves agree to work for the Aesir in the first place?
That's the heart, eh?
You lied to them.
I lied to them.
Poisoning your back!
Okay, Mimir?
To the blacksmiths of Svartalfheim, the creation of a weapon was a sacred thing. But Odin just wanted as many blades as he could get, as fast as he could get them. With every stolen resource and mediocre blade, the dwarves lost a bit of themselves.
Y'all.
One less feathery spy.
Atreus, you are getting better, faster.
I'd even be better than you one day, huh?
If you are not, I have failed.
Oh.
Is that pure Spartalfheim slag? Give it here. Whatever you need. I'll heat up the forge. Hey, what happened to all the armor we made you already?
I used it.
Well, maybe try to make this one last longer.
I will not.
Want something in particular? Whatever you need, I'll create.
Be safe.
The dwarf survived because of you.
I am not wrong there, brother. Odin would have wiped out every last dwarf in Svartalfheim. If he couldn't beat their skills, no one could.
Smell the smoke? There's another mining rig here.
You speak of your deeds with shame. Do you regret not allowing Odin to kill them?
I don't. No.
Bet we could swing across that cliff thing.
Interesting.
Thanks.
Right.
It's gotta be the right spot.
Those barrels. I smell fuel. Bet a spark from your blades would cause quite a boom.
I think we could break through the ground here. If you found a high enough place to drop from. Surprised the dwarves didn't shut these rigs off themselves.
One or two tried. The Einherjar made examples of them.
They killed the dwarves? Couldn't you have convinced them not to?
Aye. Impressive.
Should help.
Hmm. I think we can reach it there.
Yeah, that looks right. So hard.
Call so meager a task done. A wee drop out of the Asgardian occupational bucket.
You must live with your deeds, but do not be troubled by them, brother.
Oh? And why not?
You were given an impossible problem. Do not blame yourself for failing to solve it.
I'm sure the dwarves would feel differently. This doesn't fix things.
No. But it is a start.
A reminder, brother. That Spartalfheim slag we collected could be of considerable use in the hands of Brock and Sindri.
Doesn't seem like we can reach it from down here.
What
The air smells a lot cleaner. Must be because we shut down the rig. How many stories have you told about Odin and Thor, and all the bad things they've done? Let's see how many we can remember. Seems like Father could use his memory refreshed.
My memory of them requires no refreshment. They invaded our home.
Yeah, but I'm talking about history. All the other people they've hurt. Let's see. Okay. There was Thalmor, the stonemason.
Aye. He quarreled with his son. Went into the night to find him. Found Thor.
No. This is... It can't still be here.
What?
There's a key on this island. I need you to find it, brother. An innocent life is at stake.
Stop coming!
Mimir, you said an innocent life was at stake. Did Odin trap somebody here?
No, lad. I did.
Looks weak down here, father. That gear looks like it would freeze. Maybe that lift can help us get higher. Might be easier to break that ground from up there.
The key we're looking for. Now we must head to that watchtower on the shore.
What are you not saying?
The mining rigs are not the only sin I committed in Svartalfheim.
So not all dwarves can do that thing Brock and Sindri do. Right? Do they just walk between realms and turn up somewhere else?
Indeed, that's a rare skill. I gather one carefully cultivated by some secretive dwarven guild or other. Probably for the best. Them alone doing it is disconcerting enough.
Can you hear that?
No.
Thought I heard a voice.
Let's keep going, lad. Just put the key into that lock, brother. There. If you could give that drum a good loud strike.
That's the voice I heard.
I hoped it would have escaped by now, but we'll need to free it from its restraints. Something behind.
What can I make for you? Well, if you change your mind.
Ah, the mining rig's disabled. It seems a bit fresher out here.
Not seems. Is.
You're right.
What is this?
A Loonbocker. I captured it many years ago.
For Odin.
Yes. I thought it an imaginative and eye-catching way to earn his favor.
It worked?
That it did.
This creature, you enslaved it.
Aye.
But why?
Because I was young and stupid. And I didn't know what it was like to be chained in one place for years at a time, with nothing to occupy your mind but pain.
Down!
Right. We chained the fins too. If you could.
Creature's hurting,
but we're going to free it.
But it will always be chained. You know that as well as I.
Now for the other fin. There may be a way to reach it behind that collapsed debris. Angry with me, aren't you, brother?
I remember the feeling of a yoke around my neck. I would not wish it upon another.
Anything illuminating?
Enslave the creature.
Its fat was a good source of oil for Odin's lanterns.
Oil for lanterns.
Whatever anger you're feeling, whatever loathing toward me, it's nothing to what I've said to myself. The fen. If you could.
I know.
Just the tail left now.
Look out! Red
snake!
The nest was hiding some sort of device.
another of Cavassier's poems.
That dock can lead us to the tail. Let's get back to the boat.
You never spoke of this creature.
Does that surprise you? That an old man would be ashamed of the mistakes he's made.
No.
Would be long expired by now.
We could kill it.
No. Not when we can save it. Good. We can reach the tail from this dock.
Still save this broken creature.
I know what it is to be imprisoned like this. I can't just leave it.
And if it is beyond saving?
I don't understand.
Let us continue.
Find you!
Sliding down that rope should take us where we need to go. A little encouragement. Can you get me closer to its eye for a face-to-face, brother?
Yeah, I don't think we can do anything with that yet. Creature, the mining rigs. They're mistakes, Mimir. But it's Odin's fault.
That's not an excuse, little one. But thank you for saying it. You great blubbering beast. Shoo!
It's not moving.
Why is it not moving?
It has grown accustomed to its chains.
But no. No, we can fix this. We just need to chase it off and scare it. Something.
There is no making things right. Only better than they were.
The wind blowing on its face. I can feel it.
May you provide some comfort.
That's not enough.
It seldom is.
Back to Thor and Odin stories? Where were we? There was Groa, of course.
The knowledge keeper and prophet of Ragnarok. Thor murdered her husband, and Odin covered it up before doing her in himself. Ah, but enough of that for now.
Bloody grogger holes! We've got to clear out all the undead bastards!
Brother, you ever think of cooking meat with those blades of yours?
No. They would foul the meat.
Oh, because of the magic on them?
The blood.
Ah, yeah. Carry on then.
I'm here for you. I'll disinfect my tools. I'll heat up the forge. That ought to hurt him. Want something in particular? Huh. That might be my best piece yet today.
Very good.
Take care of your armor, and it'll take care of you.